Welcome to Engineer's Kitchen. When talking about Zenon, we are also talking about openness, flexibility, easy integration of third-party applications. In the last few weeks, a lot about add-ins and add-in services. Matthias, what kind of add-in service are we talking about?
In general, we have two different types of add-in services. First, we have the wizard, and then we have the service. The main difference between those two is that first, the wizard is like a one-time function. The user has actively to trigger, either in the runtime or in the zenon editor. And on the other hand, we have the zenon add-in service, which is kind of a background task which performs long-running processes.
Mm-hmm. Where is the difference to existing stuff we already have in the product?
We already have the VSTA integration, and the difference is that with the VSTA integration, we were stuck to certain versions of the .NET framework. Mm-hmm. And exactly this restriction we can therefore avoid by using the add-in service.
Wow, that sounds pretty new and pretty interesting. What are the prerequisites, or can you show us something that's behind that?
Of course, yeah. The first thing you need is, of course, zenon installation. So we started the integration of the zenon add-in framework in the version 7.60 and upwards. And the second part is you need an integrated development environment like Visual Studio. But zenon comes also with IDE called Sharp Develop, which enables you to create add-ins.
So there comes something for free from us, and there's also the professional option then with the Visual Studio, let's say.
Exactly. And for the Visual Studio integration, you will need the COPA-DATA developer tools, which you can download in the Visual Studio market. Mm-hmm. And this extension modifies your Visual Studio installation and adds certain templates that you can use to create add-ins. You have the possibility to create a new project, and there you find the SCADA add-in templates.
This looks so already like Zenon.
Mm-hmm. You have four different types: the editor service, editor wizard, project service, and the project wizard, and also two additional templates which come with a predefined WPF mm-hmm. template, let's say. Mm-hmm. And from this dialog, you can create a new project, and then you can start coding your add-in.
Mm-hmm. Cool.
You also have the possibility to do live debugging from the Visual Studio debugger in the running zenon editor or zenon runtime. Mm-hmm. And you have all the stuff you know from Visual Studio, like IntelliSense and mm-hmm. the object browser for the API.
So I guess that's one of the big differences to VSTA and the old engineering system and the old IDEs.
Exactly, yeah.
Do you also have an example which is already running? Would be interesting.
I have a small example brought with me. You can see the services uh-huh. that are running in the context of the zenon mm-hmm. editor.
So in the background there?
Exactly, yeah. Mm-hmm. A long-running process. And this service helps the engineer during the creation of the project. So it constantly monitors the actions of the engineer and displays texts or mm-hmm. static text mm-hmm. elements mm-hmm. that are not translated or do not have the right key for the translation mechanism mm-hmm. we have integrated in zenon.
Mm-hmm. So a helper tool during the engineering process to find exactly. missing keywords and whatever.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So you have this small dialog box, which shows you all the static texts that are not that have no translation keys mm-hmm. in there. So, if for example, we see here that we have a labeler and a palletizer element within our screen, and if we select it, we see that the text is not being translated by the zenon runtime at runtime.
Yeah. Now I can see it too.
Yeah. And therefore, we can look up our language files, search if we have already a certain keyword, and yeah, we are lucky, we have the right keyword, and we can simply substitute it with the respective keyword, And then you can see that the service is monitoring this change and removes the respective element automatically.
Mm-hmm. So that's a typical example for a service running in the background, doing things for you.
Exactly. So in this part, we have the service running in the context of the zenon editor, which may help you during the creation of the project. Mm-hmm. Or you can also do some sort of automatic project creation where the zenon wizard or a service gathers data from a database and creates a project based on this stuff, on this information.
Cool. So if I'm a newbie and never done anything like that, is there any help that COPA-DATA can offer, like predefined samples or documentation, or how could I approach such a thing or project?
Of course, we have lots of samples. The amount of samples is still growing. Mm-hmm. We have our own GitHub repository where developers and researchers are updating, adding samples and stuff like this. We also have so-called online help, which is helpful if you need assistance for the object model and all the functionality and stuff that you wanna use in your zenon add-ins.
So everything's in place, basically,
exactly,
to start,
yeah,
for an easy start.
Exactly.
Great. Mattia, thanks. It was a very good insight into our add-in services. As a small thank you, one of our famous Engineer's Kitchen t-shirts.
Thank you.
And hope to see you soon again on another episode of Engineer's Kitchen. What a delicious episode of COPA-DATA's Engineer's Kitchen. If you are still hungry, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.